All right, so we're checking out the Nintendo Direct. Can't stream this, so I decided just to record my reaction to it, and I'll just upload this. Don't have anything going on right now, so this is like something I can do. I feel like streaming right now isn't the best idea, but I can do a recording, edit, and put that up when I have time. No real expectations for this. I think the only real thing is like Kid Icarus Uprising if that happens. Not so confident in that, but we're about to see. I mean, I hope it'd be great to have Kid Icarus Uprising saved from the DS because that game was a lot of fun to play. I'm surprised when I played it a couple years back and it was several years of the game already came out. People were still playing that game online to that day. I feel like you go on Kid Icarus Uprising today and still find people playing stuff online. Something mature here. Okay.
We live on the continent of Elios. Four realms surrounding a holy land at its center.
It's Fire Emblem. Oh, that's Marth down there. This is definitely Fire Emblem. Endured a vicious war. Maybe I'm wrong. That looked like Marth.
We called upon heroes from other worlds to aid us. Heroes known as Emblems.
Yeah, that's Roy. It's Fire Emblem.
The warriors of our nations fought as one. In the end, we were victorious in defeating and imprisoning the Fel Dragon. In the years since, our world has been safe. But now, I sense a resurrection. The binding weakens.
Okay, yeah, the rumors of the two-tone haired protagonists that look like Joy-Cons. Also, the summoning characters is hella Awakening. Not Awakening, Heroes. So it's like Fire Emblem Heroes turned into a full video game. Yeah, there's Marth. Fire Emblem Engage.
You're awake!
Huh?
You're really awake, yeah?
1,000 years? That's how long I've been asleep.
What are those horrible things?
If I don't know about the title, but
you
New Fire Emblem.
A divine dragon, a member of a royal family of dragons revered as deities.
The war.
Your family of dragons.
Dragon. I feel like I can almost remember, but
I've had my eye on you.
The ring.
Marth, right. Sigurd, leave it to me.
Well, they're summons, and it's using, I mean, Heroes has voices for all these characters, so them doing that's not too odd.
The time has come. Now, as one, Emblem, engage!
She's like a transformation form based on the hero.
One strike will decide it all.
Oh, multiple characters can do it, okay. Okay, so you can build a team, and each person on your team can have a summon almost, which has a special form.
She asked me to gather all of the rings and bring peace back to Elios.
January. Wow, okay. Yeah, I still,
hello, everyone.
Still have to play Three Houses.
I'm Yoshiaki.
So now there's a set date when
I'll
that has to
be
played by.
For today's Nintendo Direct. What you just saw was the latest installment of the Fire Emblem series, Fire Emblem Engage.
Engage is kind of a lame title, but whatever.
Version, we'll also be releasing the Fire Emblem Engage Divine Edition, containing collectible items.
Please don't be sold through Nintendo. put it on Amazon or something.
More information about this game in the future.
Please put that somewhere.
Let's take a look at our first batch of headlines.
It takes two to tango.
It takes two. This has already been out, though.
Cody and May's relationship is on the rocks. But it gets even tougher when they're turned into dolls. To get their bodies back, they'll brave an onslaught of challenges where working together is the only way forward. Team up and cooperate with a friend in this critically acclaimed two-player platforming adventure. Even the bumpiest road can be traveled with someone by your side. Venture through fantastical worlds filled with challenging experiences around every corner.
So remember, it's just the lead dev who, like, play,
the game can also be played on two systems via local wireless or online with a pal via the free friends pass.
It was just going off on the Game Awards about
help
the Emmys.
Cody and May return to normal with a partner, of course. It Takes Two launches on the Nintendo Switch system November 4th. Pre-orders begin today on Nintendo eShop. The Forbidden Story begins.
Fatal Frame, that's the name. I'm like sitting here trying to think of the name. It's Fatal Frame, right?
After mysteriously vanishing as a child, Ruka Minazuki visits an abandoned hospital in search of her lost memories. Use the camera obscura to repel evil spirits and uncover the memories that were sealed away. A dark curse looms near. What ancient rituals will be revealed? Fatal Frame, Mask of the Lunar Eclipse launches for the first time in the West on Nintendo
Switch.
Yeah,
I'm thinking this was an older Fatal Frame by looking at it, but just never came over here.
There's a new hero who looks mechanical? Introducing Wave 2 of the Xenoblade Chronicles 3 expansion pass for the Xenoblade Chronicles 3 game. This is Ino, a new hero.
Your voice is so high-pitched.
She appears to be, mechanical? Complete her quest to have her join your party, expanding your options for classes and
Aponic
battle strategies.
Let's say version 2.0.
Challenge battles will also be added. Test your mettle in consecutive battles against tough enemies. Defeat all enemy waves to earn rewards.
See, I never played this in 2, but I definitely want to do this in 3. It's swimwear. Oh, no. Okay, we're just gonna show
will arrive in wave
level 72 boss. All right, that's
wave
fine.
Wave 2 of the Xenoblade Chronicles 3 expansion pass launches on Nintendo Switch October 13th. Get drawn into these Nintendo Switch games.
Be good that comes out with Talon Battles or something to do.
SpongeBob and Patrick make a wish that unravels the very fabric of the universe. In this 3D platforming adventure, you'll travel through portals to 7 outlandish wish worlds, like prehistoric kelp forest.
It's actually
and
like
Wild West
a Battle for Bikini Bottom 2.
Using all sorts of wacky moves, don over 30 fantastic cosmic costumes and meet your favorite Bikini Bottom residents from the TV series, voiced by their original actors.
That's it.
Soak up SpongeBob SquarePants, The Cosmic Shake, launching on Nintendo Switch next year.
Okay, so that's a while away. I was like, is it coming out soon?
Already.
No.
Fit? Box with familiar characters from Fist of the North Star.
Hello.
They'll be your instructors in exercise mode, leading you through various boxing drills. Defeat as many enemies as you can with just your fists battle mode.
Or I'm so confused how we got to
boss battles, including Jaggy.
Fitness
Boxing,
of North
Fist
Star
launches on Nintendo Switch March 2023.
It's like a Wii title.
This is your uncle's dodgeball. Throw whatever you can at opponents in this hilariously hard-hitting party game. Embrace the absurdity of frantic minigames, each one featuring ridiculous rules in madcap arenas. Customize your character from head to toe with hundreds of accessories. Plus, challenge up to 6 friends and frenemies in local and online play. They won't even know what hit them.
This game.
Oddballers launches on Nintendo Switch early next year.
Looks like a Tito game.
A small fox washes ashore on a ruined island. Brave the unknown in this isometric action-adventure game. Your only clue here is the manual. Traverse the island's interconnected realms to retrieve its missing pages.
Tunic is kind of
dangerous traps, and even
I hear very good things about Tunic, but it's out on every corner. Better consoles. It looks better than this, so I definitely get this on Xbox and not on Switch.
What long-lost secrets will the island reveal?
Because the frames are struggling on this.
September 27th. Pre-orders begin today on Nintendo eShop. New intel has arrived for these Front Mission remakes. Full remakes of 2 Front Mission games are storming in. In Front Mission 1 Remake, you'll pilot giant machines called Bonzers in tactical turn-based combat.
I see what studio makes
progress,
this, because I haven't
you'll obtain skills
heard
that can
this
help
before.
You gain the
Maybe
upper
I have,
hand
I don't.
Against opponents. You can also
don't remember
test
it.
Your metal at the Coliseum. Continue the battle in the sequel, previously unreleased outside of Japan. Take advantage of additional features like more terrain effects, weapon and armor
much better than the first
and
one.
Over 80 new skills added from
just
the first
the shots
game.
From the way characters are looking when they attack.
On Nintendo Switch
Forever Entertainment,
November.
Yep, never heard of
Front
it.
Front Mission 2 Remake will launch on Nintendo Switch next year. And in the future,
this
a remake
though.
Of Front Mission 3 will also launch on Nintendo Switch. It's a wonderful life for a new generation. After nearly 20 years, a beloved farming experience is reborn. Welcome back to Forgotten Valley. Here, you'll manage a farm passed down to you by your father.
Story of Seasons.
Restore and expand your farm.
I can't remember if Story of Seasons is
care for your friendly animals.
The original creator of Harvest Moon? Or if it's just
befriend the townsfolk while you're out and about in the valley.
Whoever got the rights to it, holding it still.
You might even meet your future partner and start a family. In this installment, those around you will grow older as time goes on. Their appearances will change over the years. Your child will also choose their career based on how you raise them.
Get old.
An especially wonderful farm life in Forgotten Valley lies ahead. Story of Seasons. A Wonderful Life launches on Nintendo Switch, summer 2023.
Okay, Splatoon 3. What are we talking about, though? Splatfest? Down repping the Splatlands. We are Deep Cut Anarchy Splatcast. We're live. Now it's time. Yeah, Splatfest. Eh.
The first post-launch Splatfest for Splatoon 3 has been confirmed. Here's the theme.
Not try again.
To a deserted island.
Oh,
gear,
God.
Grub or fun?
Another try battle.
So many
it looks more spread out. So hopefully this is better.
And more free updates are planned for Splatoon 3.
Yeah, then the game needs more emotes.
More info in the future.
Because there's like not enough right now.
So, Squids, what did you think? What would you bring to a deserted island?
That game sold like 3.2 million
as
in
for
Japan.
Me, I've
that
already
is
decided.
Insane.
I hope
in 3 days.
All participate as well.
See, the answer for me is
next,
probably
please
gear.
Take a look at this.
Because with gear, you can get the other ones. But, gotta see what other people are picking. Am I on Breath of the Wild? But then Square Enix, so this Octopath too? It is. Wow. I honestly didn't expect that.
A brand new game in the Octopath Traveler series. 8 new travelers embark on a journey through the land of Celestia.
With that, we could realize a world without conflict, without bloodshed.
I'm going to become a star and bring smiles to people's faces, just like Mama.
Octopath did very well. I'll be back once that's actually her daughter. Devil called poverty
from the world. The man who took everything from me shall die by my hand.
Not again. Not this stench. The stench of blood.
Doubt is what I do.
So this seems like it's actually
Leave
just like
hunting to me.
Fully in the same timeline
the tasty
then.
Meat you want. I need to rediscover who I am.
Maybe not.
Explore a
but that's
wide
just the idea I get from it.
Set in a bustling era. Each traveler's path action differs between day and night.
Our Lord knows well the ways of the world.
What will happen when their paths intertwine?
What's that big realm?
Let's go, Temenos.
And what adventures await them in this new world?
I think I found a source.
The 8 travelers each have their own story to tell. Where will their journeys lead them and you?
I gotta play the first one still. And Triangle Strategy as well eventually.
Launches on Nintendo Switch February 24th, 2023.
There are so many games. Just
what you just saw was Octopath Traveler 2 from Square Enix. Please look forward to the journeys of 8 new heroes. Let's see some more headlines.
Okay, so Nintendo is actually announcing a lot of new interesting things. Another farming sim.
Welcome to your new fairy tale life. Octopath
2, new Fire Emblem.
Cultivate your homestead and forge everlasting friendships in this farm simulation RPG. Discover magical spells to grow crops. Face off against mischievous foes. And explore the enchanted realms of Azoria.
It's the new farming
Along
sim
the way,
thing.
You'll be friends with an RPG cast of characters who call this island their home. Tend and grow your fairy tale farmstead solo or together with up to 4 players in local online
guessing this was co-op.
By gathering
not just
resources
NPCs.
And crafting items, you'll be able to customize your home and enjoy this mesmerizing adventure even more. As the seasons change, new spellbinding surprises can be unlocked that'll help you restore Azoria to its natural splendor. Magic awaits in Fae Farm. Launching exclusively on Nintendo Switch, Spring 2023. It's a musical blast from the past. Celebrate the 35th anniversary of the Final Fantasy series with the latest theater rhythm game. Enjoy iconic songs like One Winged Angel, Torn from the Heavens, Tsuteki Dane, and more. There are 385 songs total. Songs are categorized by game, so you can play each stage while experiencing the series through the music. In addition, 2 players locally can complete stages in pair style, while up to 4 players can battle to the beat in online multi-battle. Theater Rhythm Final Bar Line begins its symphony on the Nintendo Switch system February 16th, 2023. Pre-orders begin today on Nintendo eShop. After the game's launch, pay DLC songs from the Saga series.
Not you.
Nier series. Octopath Traveler. Live Alive and more will be released. That's 90 additional songs.
Jesus,
plus,
okay.
Editions containing a season pass and 27 extra songs, including Melodies of Life, will be available.
Deluxe and digital premium editions. I don't know about that.
A cosmic adventure is just around the corner.
Are you ready?
Blast off on an adventure of galactic proportions.
Bro, it's
with
only
Mario
been 20 minutes.
The
There's still so much more.
Let's dive into exploration. Freely roam through all sorts of wondrous worlds, each one jam-packed with discoveries. Find coins. Unlock hidden paths. And help out the locals with their troubles.
You say cheap tuna?
At shops, you can get items that'll come in handy during battles. After each quest or battle, your team will earn rewards.
So the fact that Rayman
stronger.
Is going
to
be in this game is cool, but like him being DLC is kind of
each with their own special powers and skills. They can help spark a decisive victory. Can Mario and the Rabbids put an end to the darkness? Mario plus Rabbids Sparks of Hope launches on Nintendo Switch October 20th. Pre-orders are available now on Nintendo eShop. A gold edition can also be pre-ordered, containing the base game, weapon skins, and a season pass.
Oh, it comes with the... Oh, no. Never mind.
Restore
I thought it was the first game, but no, it's the base game
and
extra
monsters.
Stuff.
Rune Factory 3 returns on Nintendo Switch. Take a break from quests to chat with the locals, cultivate crops, and care for monsters, among other relaxing activities.
Farming RPG.
You can also transform
so many farming sims.
Into a monster? Your abilities in battle and conversations with the locals will vary depending on your form. Your choices will also cause different events to occur. Plus, a brand new mode has been added to help you enjoy more quality time with your in-game
spouse. The screen tearing when they're walking around.
Rune Factory 3 Special launches on Nintendo Switch next year.
And now they're announcing the new one.
Plus, a new Rune Factory series will launch in the future.
A new series, not even a new game, a new series.
More Nintendo 64 games are on the way.
Oh yeah, Centaur is 64. NSO. Normally.
Mario Party.
Okay, original Mario Party on NSO
Mario
sounds really
Party
good.
2.
So yeah, this is smart.
Mario Party 3.
This is very smart, actually.
Pokemon Stadium.
Hey, playing Stadium with people could be
Pokemon
cool.
Pokemon Stadium 2. 1080 snowboarding. Excitebike 64. These games will gradually be added in the future. You can play a selection of Nintendo 64 games and enjoy many more gaming benefits.
I see why they held
Nintendo
out on the
Switch
Mario Party
Online
stuff.
Plus expansion pack membership.
Because it made sense to wait till after Super Mario
more
Party.
Game we should mention.
Oh, 007. Okay, yeah. Yeah, the fact they got GoldenEye back with online play and makes that NSO pack much better.
Nintendo Switch games. Live your best life on the newly discovered continent of Antoisia in this immersive RPG. Perform over 100 types of daily tasks to build character and deepen your relationships with the locals. In doing so, you'll gain access to different job classes and abilities. A grand adventure into the unknown awaits. Various Daylight launches on Nintendo Switch later today.
I'm like, this looks like Square. Yes, it's Square Enix. Yes. Yes, indeed. That looks like a brief title font.
Strange planet. Build a new rocket from scratch in this management sim game. Scour the planet for materials. Then build machines to refine them into various resources. Eventually, you'll construct multiple production lines like these. But the planet's creatures will attack, so keep them at bay. Factorio launches on Nintendo Switch October 28th. A young girl named Ib visits an art museum with her parents in this 2D exploration adventure.
She wanders through a busy gallery by the artist Guertena until one particular piece draws her in. Will she be able to safely return to her own world? Every decision affects her fate in IB. Launching on Nintendo Switch, spring 2023.
Mario Strikers Battle League, where eight players locally on one system can get gritty, is getting a second free update. Joining the roster are Pauline, a physical powerhouse with fast movements and strong tackles.
He's gonna be busted because he's a physical powerhouse.
A midfield speedster with dazzling techniques and high pass accuracy. Plus, more gear and another stadium are being added. The second free update launches this month.
Guys, Strikers aren't so cool, but it just sucks. That game is, sucks.
Final summer begins.
Sucks. Oh well. Maybe you'll get them next time in 10 years. They do another one.
When strange islands suddenly appear, Ryza and friends set sail to investigate in order to protect their homeland.
Never seen this game series before.
Sprawling landscapes set the stage for your adventure. Freely explore this vast world and forge your own path in this charming RPG. 11 heroes from all walks of life will join your party. During battle, work with your allies to activate various skills, which can be swapped out when needed. Teamwork is paramount after all. New features are also in store. The keys to this lively adventure are in your hands. Atelier Ryza 3, Alchemist of the End and the Secret Key launches on the Nintendo Switch system February 24th.
Oh, it's Koei Tecmo. That did not look like a Koei Tecmo game. Interesting.
Wave 3 is on the way. Here's a sneak peek at two courses racing into Wave 3. Merry Mountain from Mario Kart Tour.
Sneak peek at two courses. Why not just show off the courses for the next wave?
Peach Gardens from Mario Kart DS.
I love DS. And DS and 7 are like my two favorite Mario Kart games. I personally don't really care for 8, so don't even play it.
Wave 3 of the Mario Kart 8 Deluxe Booster Course Pass DLC for
the 8
Mario
is about to
Kart
be the definitive Mario Kart.
Launches this holiday.
Unfortunately, but for people who like it.
Active Nintendo Switch Online Plus
one.
Expansion Pack members can enjoy this DLC at no additional cost. The DLC can also be purchased on its own.
How was that? Next, we have some news to share about Nintendo Switch Sports. In the next free update, golf will be added.
I forgot this game existed. Also from the Wii Sports series include.
Of course,
that's
you
cool,
can play
at least.
These locally. Additionally, up to 8 players online can play at the same time on the same course in survival golf. Those with the most strokes will be out. We previously announced that the update would release this fall. However, we'd like a bit more time for development, so the update is now planned for this holiday. Please wait just a little longer. Next, we have a special guest.
Okay, is this going to be the movie?
Hello, it's been a while. I'm Shigeru Miyamoto. I have a few things I'd like to share with you today, including some news.
Of course, news,
first,
yes.
As you may have heard, the Super Mario Bros. Animated movie we're developing with Chris Meledandri from Illumination will release next spring.
Yes.
And Super Nintendo World, which is entering its second year at Universal Studios Japan, will also open in Hollywood, California in the US. Recently, we've been
excited
working
for that.
On the finishing touches for both. Today, I'd like to talk a little bit about Pikmin.
Wait, what?
It's been over 20 years since the first game, and we're still working on the series. This is Pikmin Bloom.
Okay,
it's
okay
a smart
this.
Device game we started with Niantic late last year.
In which talk about Pikmin.
All
excited?
The world are planting
Pikmin
flowers.
Bloom. Yeah, no, not interesting.
Here's a quick rundown of the game for those who have yet to play it. Pikmin Bloom is a smart device game that uses your location. By walking outside, you can find Pikmin, raise them, and plant flowers together. All you need to do is take it with you on your daily walks or outings. You can look back at the end of the day and see where you walked. Send out Pikmin and collect the items they found that day, and feed them nectar to increase their petals. So, how many steps did we take today? While you're out and about, you can also use the AR feature to take photos with Pikmin.
Like, Pokemon Go exists
all around you.
Why?
Let's
like,
take a quick look.
It's just to me, it's, Pikmin Bloom's like weird because it's like
I have nearly
Nintendo already
Pikmin.
Has Pokemon Go, which is super
they
successful.
Nectar.
I was like, yeah, let's do it with Pikmin
if
too.
If you give Pikmin nectar like you see here,
said,
their flowers will bloom.
Pikmin are nowhere near as interesting as.
You'll also see the number
finding
of
and capturing Pokemon when they're out and about.
Regarding the map, the clouds
care about
will clear
no
along
Pikmin
the
while
walk
around. I want
so
a Pikmin video game.
Locations you've visited. I normally move around within Kyoto, but I've also been going to Osaka, to Universal Studios Japan. I occasionally go to Tokyo as well. You'll say to yourself, okay, this time I'll try walking here. It makes trips and walks a lot of fun.
I mean, this is a cool feature that they should put into Pokemon Go.
Enjoy just by taking it with you.
But,
I hope you'll try it out. Okay, now to the main event. Please take a look at this.
Pikmin 4, please. Thank you. Okay. Pikmin Bloom. They have to do that first, then actually do the main thing. Everyone learned from Blizzard's Diablo Immortal announcement. Next year. God, Nintendo has so many games.
That's right. Pikmin 4 will launch in 2023. We won't be showing any gameplay today. However, you'll be able to play like this. From the Pikmin's perspective near the ground.
Okay, so that's a pilot from Pikmin 3.
I also made a new t-shirt. Nintendo Switch has made controlling the game simpler, meaning you can further concentrate on the core essence of Pikmin gameplay. We call it Dandori in Japanese, or strategically planning, deploying, and commanding the Pikmin. I hope you're all looking forward to Pikmin 4. Thank you, Mr. Koizumi.
I actually didn't talk about the movie.
Thank you very much, Mr. Miyamoto.
No, I'm much more excited for Pikmin 4.
Now, let's move on
than
to
movie
more
news.
Headlines.
100%.
Take your dancing game to the next level.
Oh, this is Just Dance. Okay, and now it's muted. Before this whole thing gets muted. But yeah, Just Dance. Yeah. Now, typical Ubisoft, something works, we'll run it into the ground. I mean, Just Dance is unique enough, but it's just like they release this every year. And so at that point, it will lose interest, but Ubisoft always does this formula that works. Okay, that's cool. Let's just release it again. And again. And again. Oh, and... Okay. Never ending? Don't... Live service stuff just don't work. But every company wants to have a live service.
Season of death. As you cultivate a peaceful farm
okay,
life
that's
in
like
the village of Leap,
five of these, but Harvestia is the best.
The season of death quietus continuously
of
returns,
all of these,
to destroy all.
Travel farming
the
sims, but
the
farming sim RPG is like.
In this life simulation
why
there's
so many of them?
Along the way, allies with different motives will join your cause. While facing numerous dangers, you'll begin to uncover the truth of this ill-fated world. After this presentation, a demo containing the opening days of your farm's first season will be available on Nintendo eShop. Save data can be transferred to the full game once
purchased.
Really
cool.
Harvestella launches on Nintendo Switch November 4th. Get ready for a devilishly good time.
Some new Bayonetta 3 news. Okay, this is where the M rating came from.
After 500 years, Umbra Witch Bayonetta was revived in the present day. In the first Bayonetta game, she clashed with angels to recover her lost memories. And in the second, confronted demons to save her best friend. Now, in this third installment, she'll fight to protect the world from the sudden invasion of man-made bioweapons called homunculi.
Don't worry, I know this song by heart.
She's gone from fighting for herself to fighting for others to fighting for the world. Those who have overcome their past histories with Bayonetta to fight alongside her include the journalist Luca and another Umbra witch, Jean. New ally Viola also joins in on the action. A hair-raising, demon-summoning,
I see what you did
globe-trotting
there.
Adventure awaits in Bayonetta 3, launching on Nintendo Switch October 28th. Pre-orders are available now on Nintendo eShop. After today's Nintendo Direct, a new trailer delving more into gameplay will launch on our official
YouTube channel.
The
frame rate on that trailer
looks
really good. Everything they've shown, that frame rate looks very good.
A dark fantasy mystery abounds from the creators of Danganronpa.
Okay, I was like, the art style looks... Oh yeah, Danganronpa, yeah, that's
welcome
it.
To the city of perpetual rain. Many cases remain unsolved in this corporate-controlled metropolis. Those who investigate are called master detectives, who come from all around the world.
Yeah, these are Danganronpa characters.
What?
Meet Yuma, an amnesiac detective. And Shinigami, the spirit haunting him after their pact.
Shinigami?
Dive into these unsolved cases as a trainee at the detective agency. Thoroughly inspect each crime scene to gather clues and evidence. When you're ready, Shinigami will conjure a realm tying the crime scene to the truth. A mystery labyrinth. Overcome obstacles and manifestations of mysteries to edge closer to the actual events. Mystery phantoms will attempt to hinder your progress during each case.
Trial? I can't remember what it's called.
Avoid their barrage of falsehoods
made that a little
and
more
slash
interesting.
Through contradictions. Uncover the secrets
not more interesting,
of
but made it more
Master Detective
like...
Archives, Rain Code, launching first on the Nintendo Switch
the
system, Spring 2023.
It's more gameplay-based rather than the way traditional Danganronpa is.
If you dare... The latest installment in the Resident Evil series is coming to
good,
Nintendo
actually.
Switch as a cloud version.
Yes, it needs to be a cloud version. It's not going to run on the Switch, so that looks
Ethan
good.
Ethan Winters must face the horrors of the village and its four fearsome lords to rescue his abducted daughter. Resident Evil Village Cloud launches on Nintendo Switch October 28th. You can download and try out the free demo today on
the
Nintendo.
This doesn't have the updates,
to
though.
Pre-order the full game.
I guess I could always just add that later.
The Winter's Expansion DLC.
Oh, no, there it is.
Containing a new third-person mode, additional story content, and more will launch December 2nd. Additionally, three other recent entries in the Resident Evil series will be available as cloud versions on Nintendo Switch this year.
I mean, yeah, Resident Evil is a game that probably needs to be on cloud, especially with the new RE engine stuff. I don't think the Switch is going to run that well.
It's an action-packed lineup of Nintendo Switch games.
But Kingdom Hearts being cloud-based makes no sense.
Vanquish foes to avenge your father in this kung fu action brawler by thrusting, tripping,
this does not look very good on the Switch.
You'll break their stance and gain the upper hand. Fall in
combat,
the
norm.
And you'll get older and weaker. In turn, however, you'll learn new techniques to complete your mission. Can you exact revenge before your time runs out? Sifu pummels its way onto Nintendo Switch November 8th. Pre-orders begin today on Nintendo eShop. experience the events leading up to Final Fantasy VII.
I was like, it's not remake, right? RPG. No, it's a reunion.
Zack Fair is a young and ambitious soldier operative aspiring to become a hero.
I'm surprised this is launching on consoles besides PlayStation.
He investigates strange disappearances within his elite unit. This remaster features enhanced HD graphics, an updated combat system, and new soundtrack arrangements. Crisis Core Final Fantasy VII Reunion launches on Nintendo Switch December 13th. The classic arcade shoot-em-up Radiant Silvergun is coming to Nintendo Switch. Fire different types of weapons to take down waves of enemies.
I really like these kind of arcade games. I don't think I've played this one before.
Color for a chain bonus, or take down differently colored ones for a secret bonus. Rack up these bonuses for a high score.
I used to love playing these at arcades.
Radiant Silvergun launches on Nintendo Switch later today. Recruit a team of shipwrecked heroes and make your way out of a derelict space station in this roguelike game set in the endless universe. But it's not as easy as it sounds. You'll have to fend off continuous waves of monsters as you make your way through procedurally generated levels. Complete various quests to unlock new heroes, weapons, station areas, and more. Up to three players in online co-op can attempt to escape their grim fate. Do you have what it takes?
Endless Dungeon launches on
Nintendo Switch next year.
Oh, that's a while away. Okay.
The journey of world regeneration begins anew. Remaster of Tales of Symphonia is coming to Nintendo Switch.
Okay, but not.
The world of Silveront is controlled by shadowy forces called Desaians. To stop them, a person known as the Chosen One must ascend the Tower of Salvation.
Looks so great. I'm guessing it's Replication. Replication. It's what they looked like. The current Chosen One
and his childhood friend in this beloved action RPG. They'll meet allies along the way.
For a remaster,
like
I think he would change it.
Aristocrat, Zelos. And okay, a lumberjack who lost her emotions after an experiment, Prisea. Other allies will also join the party.
Because
the fate of two interconnected worlds.
Newer Tales games look way better, so I'm very surprised they didn't update this and decide, yeah, we're just gonna make it similar to what it originally was. That, I feel like that's a bad decision. Believe this is fine? Probably not. Everybody wants a kart racer now.
Kirby's Return to Dreamland Deluxe is coming to Nintendo Switch.
I thought it was just Dreamland again. Yep.
One day, a spaceship crash lands on planet Popstar.
Getting brought to Switch.
To help Magalore return to his home planet, Kirby and his friends set off on an adventure. In addition to Sword, Whip, and other familiar copy abilities, the new Mecha copy ability makes its debut. Blast foes from a distance, or punch them up close. It's packed with other powerful moves as well. The game supports local play for up to four players on the same system. Plus, everyone can play as Kirby while using their favorite copy abilities. There's also a collection of sub-games.
I don't remember the original game. That might be new.
This includes the new sub-game Magalore's Tome Trackers. And returning ones like Samurai Kirby. All subgames can be played with up to four players.
An Air Ride Warp Star, I think of the name. For a second.
Kirby. Kirby's Return to Dream Land Deluxe launches on the Nintendo Switch system February 24th, 2023. Pre-orders begin today on Nintendo eShop.
As part of Kirby's 30th anniversary, a remake of Kirby's Return to Dream Land will be released. We hope you're looking forward to this game. Thank you for watching today's Nintendo
A remake? Direct. Return to Dream? Was that wrong? I'm trying to understand a remake of that. Because didn't you just show Dream Land Deluxe? Or are you just talking about that game? Okay, this has to be Breath of the Wild. Oh yeah, for sure it is. Okay. Haven't heard news about this in so long. Almost looks like Majora's Mask. Almost. Not really though. Almost. The Sheikah Shield? We're getting a type? Tears of the Kingdom, okay. So it seems like the Breath of the Wild is going to be Zelda something of the... We got a date. Wait, I think the original Breath of the Wild was around that date too. Okay, that's exciting. I think the original Breath of the Wild was around that date. Let me double check. Because it was when the Switch released. What was the Switch release date? March 3rd. Okay, so it's 2 months later, but it was around the same time period. Well, I mean, instead of Direct, Nintendo actually had a lot of cool stuff in there. Yeah, I get to get when their Direct actually started. So, new Fire Emblem is big, because this has been rumored and leaked for ages. I actually like the way they're doing the summoning style. I think this style, Dragon Child slash Dragon, interesting. But I think this style is an interesting way of doing it. So you have rings, and you put the rings on your party member, and then that gives them a character, and then you can even have like a fusion form. This is almost very the Fire Emblem Persona crossover thing. It's FE, that one. It's very FE-ish, while a bit of Heroes. So. Depending on how many of these are in the game, this can be a really cool system. What else? Definitely not It Takes Two. What is essentially Battle for Bikini Bottom 2 is cool. Splatfest, obviously, that tri-battle was pretty bad. Octopath 2 is a cool one. Care about this. Don't really care about that. Not that. GoldenEye on NSO is smart. Pikmin 4. To Not Just Dance. And then we finally got a title for Breath of the Wild. So let me get the right name now that we actually have one. A title and a date. Tears of the Kingdom, yeah. So the Breath of the Wild sequel. But the thing is, we know still this is the sequel to Breath of the Wild. They confirmed that. Legend of Zelda, Tears of the Kingdom. So finally have a title for this game. Yeah, the Nintendo did really well. Sony's not living up to this. I'm not going to lie to you. Probably not even going to react to that one. Sony's not going to live up to this. But this was cool. So I'm very excited what Nintendo's got here. Because they've got some good stuff. Like this alone would have been big. But new Fire Emblem. Pikmin 4. Tears of the Kingdom. Octopath 2. A decent bit of filler in there. Okay, there's also... I see, speaking of which, I need to play Three Houses, but I think this is really smart because all these characters have voices now, because in Heroes, they're all voiced. So they have voice actors for every single major Fire Emblem character at this point. Yeah, I really need this to not be through their store, because I ordered the Xenoblade one, by the way. I still don't have my physical game. So I need to message Nintendo about that, because yeah, never got the physical game. I would like to have that. Also, the cards are probably way more than this, because like in the art, we saw Roy for sure. So you can imagine major characters are going to be in it. So like Roy, Ike, probably all the major lords for sure will probably be a part of that. Because I know I saw Roy in the, I want to say the Burning Blade. I feel like that's not actually the name of his weapon, but it's always what I just call it. It's like, the name of his game. Oh yeah, the Xenoblade 2 expansion is a, well, minor three minor expansion is next month. Gotta finish that game. It's Japan Time wants to start talking about the ending, and I'm like in middle of chapter 5, so I gotta start moving. That's what we'll be doing on stream this week, since I finished all the Splatoon single player stuff. Now it's basically multiplayer when I want to play with people, or just random Salmon Run. So yeah, a lot of farming sims, but I think this one's the best, in terms of my opinion. But there was a lot of farming sims. Like people, the Fantasticast always talks about Game Awards being, oh, it's the space shooter game. Every single space shooter. There was a lot of farming sim RPGs in this. I'm surprised they put in that many. Yeah, after playing the remake of Berseria, making it this chibi style and not just making a more updated style, it's kind of lame. I get the original game was like this, but I don't know. Tales of series just looks way better than this. So doing this is cheaper and lame. All right, but that's it for me. Cool stuff here. I wasn't blown away, really. Kind of expected some things, but definitely excited, especially for this one. Fire Emblem in this one, for sure. Very excited for Pikmin 4 too, but I gotta play Pikmin 3, I gotta play Three Houses, I gotta play Octopath Traveler. A lot of games to play to try and catch up to some of these, but 100% playing this when it drops. I love Breath of the Wild. So very excited for this, and see what they got cooking up now that we finally have a title for this game. Alright, but that's it for me. Catch you guys later. This is what you need.